Well, Matt Pryor, this is it. In a flash, we've got another Ashes series. I mean, it's only 5 minutes ago. You were celebrating the 3-0, but no rest for the wicked, hey?
No rest for the wicked, indeed. It's really exciting. First time there's been an Ashes, back-to-back Ashes series. And it's an absolute privilege to play in one of them, let alone, get the opportunity to play in another one. Playing cricket in Australia is something I thoroughly enjoy as well. Fantastic country, so looking forward to it. It's also getting chilly now, so it's about time to get over to warmer climates.
Now, this Ashes thing, you've played in how many now?
Three.
Okay, defeats?
None.
Zero. It's not bad, this, is it?
It's okay. At the moment, it's okay. And a 4-from-4 would be very, very special. Obviously, it's a huge carry at the end, but a lot of hard work before him.
Now, Australia are a difficult side to beat. There's never such a thing as a bad Australian side, and they are getting better. So there's reasons to suggest that they're going to give you a hell of a series. But on the flip side, 3-0, pretty impressive. But, like yourself and others, probably didn't play 100% your best. So if you guys step up a gear as well, yeah, That's the reason why you're going to win.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, we know we didn't play our best cricket during the summer, but we still won 3-0. So that's actually very exciting for us. If we play the brand of cricket we want to play and we know we can play, and we have played in the past, then, it looks very promising. But as you say, the Aussies are a tough team to beat anywhere, let alone in their own backyards. We're going to have to play better than we did this summer if we want to win. But, you look around the dressing room, the skill and ability that we have in that room, the individuals we have in the room, I'm certain we'll get a good result.
That's a really interesting point you made there, Matt. If Australia improve, and we all think they will, then you actually have to play better than you did. Even though you won 3-0, you need to play better to win the series.
Yeah, I think, whatever the Aussies do, we can't worry about what they do. We have to just make sure we control what we do. I think that we are ready to play some really good cricket. Our batters are ready to score big runs, and we know what our bowlers can do, and we know they'll take 20 wickets. So it's just really, really exciting times ahead.
And the funny thing is you say, you won 3-0, so it sounds churlish to nitpick, but there's, you didn't play at your best. So I guess, end result, lovely, you won the Ashes, but there's a lot of you, yourself with the runs, even the captain, probably by his ridiculous standards, Trotty, there's a few who probably, not Ian Bell, who would like to, summer was great, but I wouldn't mind sticking some runs on the board this time.
Yeah, look, first and foremost, the important thing is winning. That's all you're worried about. If the team wins, then you're happy. But of course, guys, individuals want to perform all the time. It's not possible. But certainly there are a few guys that, myself included, that want to have a good series and score some runs.
Yeah, now, of course, memories from the last Ashes series done under are, apart from Perth, are excellent, aren't they? And that was sort of classic. You scored ridiculous amounts of runs, ground them down, and then got them out. So, is that about conditions, or is that about mindset, or both? What is there to be positive about you guys going down there?
I think the conditions. I think our batters like batting on those wickets with a bit more bounce and pace. I think you always need a bit of luck as well. You need a few things to go your way to score big runs. But certainly, I think getting on the aeroplane to go to Australia, there's a lot of positives there. It's not like if we're going to India and we know the wickets don't really suit us, a lot of spin bowling or whatever it may be. We know that going to Australia, the wickets suit us and we can play some really good cricket out.
Yeah, now, I don't know whether you're old enough, you probably are actually, aren't you, to remember the days when Australia had their knee on the English jugular and just kept it there and kept it there and kept it there. So, no time to start feeling sorry for them. You've won your last three Ashes series. I think you've won, four out of the last five as well. But no reason to go soft on them, is there?
No, certainly not. One of the things this team wants to be is a ruthless, ruthless group team. And in order to be that, you have to keep winning. And when you get in strong positions, you want to keep your foot on the throat. And really punch home your advantage. So that's what we'll try and do now. Obviously we've won the last three, but it all starts again. It would be great to win four, but it's a lot of work, a lot of skill needed to win those test matches.
Good thing about being a keeper is that you don't have to go down to long leg and cop all the abuse from the stand. You guys are going to get some. In fact, the chat started almost before the last Ashes series ended. Is that water for ducks back? I mean, it's going to be intense, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It is, because any time you go and play cricket in Australia, you get abuse. So it's no different, and they can't do any more than they do any other time. It's just, I think this time it's more spoken about. It's going to be documented more and written about in the press. But as I say, it's not as if they're suddenly going to pipe up.
Sure.
They have done every time we've been in Australia.
And the answer is not a smart response, I take it. The answer is a ton.
Exactly. All we can do is go over there and play well, win games, win test matches. That's ultimately what it's about. It's not about what you say off the pitch, or, as you say, coming back with a, you know, smart retort or something like that. It's about scoring hundreds, taking wickets, winning test matches. Get back on the plane with the Ashes.
Yeah, and I mean, how many tests do you play now, Matt?
73.
Oh, who's counting, hey?
Something like that.
As enthusiastic, I know you've got a long flight ahead of you and you say goodbye to the family, but once you touch Australian soil, you feel that warm sun in your face. Mm. Your 74th test, as upbeat and as enthusiastic as your first?
Oh, absolutely. Well, fingers crossed, injury, you know, away and stuff like that, but first test at the Gabba, amazing cricket ground, in the Ashes. Can't wait, really excited about it, hugely motivated for it.
And have you had time to do anything else? Because of course you were playing for Sussex, weren't you, until the end of the championship season, which was only a handful of weeks away. So
yeah.
You've been away on a bonding camp with England. Good to see that you've survived that. But have you had time away? Done anything?
Yeah, had a couple of weeks holiday, which was lovely. And I've spent a huge amount of time on the bike. Obviously it's been training for the Ashes, but it's still, you know, I find it a great form of escapism as well, so I've enjoyed that. And it's been nice just to be at home for a while and be with the family, and enjoy time with the kids and stuff like that. So it's been great. It's been a nice little break, but now it's time for business again.
Okay, now listen, you guys are going to be responsible for a lot of sickies at work, a lot of people with black rings under their eyes. I got caught out last time. I just catch an hour of the opening session, and before you know it, it's two in the morning.
And
the problem is then you wake up early, and instead of just rolling over, you think, oh, I might catch the last session as well. So are you going to make it worth it for us?
I certainly hope so. I've already had a lot of text messages from people saying, oh, I'm not looking forward to these late nights again. It all starts again. The support for the England cricket team is massive, and it really isn't lost on the team either. We know how many people are, you know, pulling those sickies and having those late nights just to support the team and get behind us, and hopefully we can reward them with some good performances and ultimately, you know, keeping the urn safely tucked away here at the home of cricket.
Keep it at the home of cricket. Well, listen, travel well.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Thank you very much.